first things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of my sea. Oh,
all right. Well, I felt like that was a fitting introduction to this session. It's 40 under 40. It's something that we need to be celebrating, and it's get excited about. It's hard to get excited when we're thousands of miles apart, but we're doing our best. So welcome, everyone. I'm Nelson Spencer, Jr. with the Waterways Journal, currently publisher. Many of you know me as Spence. The 40 under 40 awards is something we started a few years back to really recognize the up and comers of the industry. It's also an opportunity for us to celebrate what we have as an industry and hopefully encourage others to join and take advantage of the job opportunities the barge industry and all those who service it can provide, which are some really good opportunities. We're really, really excited about this group. To get started, I want to let everyone know that there's a chat feature on your right, and we'd really like to get everyone to start participating in this. And so for those 40 under 40 winners on the call today, I'd like you to go in there and tell everyone you're here. Do something to let everyone know your presence so we can start getting some discussion going. This year is going to be more or less reading off your names, giving a few quotes and a few quotes from those who nominated you and your fellow peers, and then we'll hopefully hear some dialogue in the chat. That'll be the networking, and of course in 2021 when we're hopefully back to being live, we'll look forward to handing you award and doing this right with the award in hand. So you will be invited to that as well. James, let's go ahead and get started here.
Sure, Spence. Let's start off by just doing the first slide that has some of our winners. Justin Apgar, 39. He's the director of new construction as well as the compliance officer at Superior Marine Ways Incorporated out of South Point, Ohio. Apgar quickly became an expert on regulations from the Environmental Protection Agency, Corps of Engineers, Occupational Safety and Health Administration, and Coast Guard, and helped Superior advance its policies and procedures, said CEO Michael Mann. Next, we have Christian Barger. Lieutenant Commander Chris Barger, 38, is Chief of the Coast Guard's Waterways Management Division at Sector Upper Mississippi River, based in St. Louis, Missouri. In reference to the historic 2019 flooding, they said, in response to this catastrophic event, Lieutenant Commander Barger leveraged the full power of the Waterways Management Division and provided an unprecedented level of service and responsiveness to the maritime community, according to Deputy Sector Commander Richard Scott. And third, we have Blake Boyd. Blake Boyd, 36, is the Chief Operating Officer of Towworks LLC, based in Lake Jackson, Texas. By adding real-world experience and methods to Towworks, he has been able to bring the new unit tow, shore tankering, and voyage planning modules online over the last 2 years while assisting with the completion of the maintenance and the compliance modules that allow Towworks to offer marine management and sub-M software needs, said John Cox, Towworks Vice President of Client Services. Spence?
All right. Yeah, I'll do this.
Okay, sounds well. Good.
All right. Another thing about that song before we continue. I don't know if you were paying attention, but those of you who are getting this award, those who are 40 and under, most likely are familiar with the band Imagine Dragons. But when we were going through these songs, I didn't realize that it brought up Master of the Seas. So I don't know if you caught that, but kind of a good tie-in. All right, so Vanessa Breslin, 34, is Human Resources Manager for Canal Barge Company, based in New Orleans. While working at Canal Barge, Breslin has developed a thorough understanding of the company's culture and people needs and actively supports its strategic direction, said Michael Breslin, port captain for Turn Services. Vanessa, I was also on the phone with Merritt Lane earlier, and he presented, and he also said how excited he was and deserving you are of the award. Then we have Jacob Brown, who I've spoken with lately in their projects for Campbell Transportation. Jacob's 31. He's already the director of marine maintenance for Enterprise Marine Services, their construction and shipyard operations based in Houma, Louisiana. He has been involved in the development of several new initiatives in the field of maintenance, repair, and construction that stand to provide significant benefit to the industry as a whole in the future, said Lance Sanino, partner at Jones Walker. Then third on this slide, we have Captain Shane Checkin. He's a general manager of industry terminal and salvage. And according to Bradley Busato, president, he hired Shane to be the logistics coordinator. Within 2 years, his incredible organizational skills and ability to problem solve complex issues made him the logical choice for promotion to general manager. Congrats all.
Okay, so Whitney Cruz. Whitney Cruz, 34, is vice president of Barge Logistics for Marquette Transportation, Inc. in Paducah, Kentucky. She's an exemplar of leadership and a dedication to her field and team, said Anna Whitmore, Marquette's vice president of sales and logistics. This is shown on a day-to-day basis in and out of the office. Her passion for the maritime industry is something to be emulated. Her positive and ambitious attitude has been an important factor in the expansion of the Women in Maritime Operations organization, Human Resources Director Dana Tappan said. Ashley Danielson is 34. She's the Vice President of Marine Administration for Genesis Marine of Houston, Texas. She serves on the Board of Directors of the American Waterways Operators. Jim Farley, the President of Larkspur Consulting, said Danielson is smart, hardworking, and a true credit to Genesis Marine and the barge industry. Brandon Davison, 36, is Manager of Logistics and Marketing for the Heinz Furlong Line, based out of Nashville, Tennessee. Brandon is energetic and loves the challenges that our industry throws at us each day, Glenn Hinden, Heinz Furlong Chief Operating Officer, said. The river is in his blood, and he's in for the long haul and will play a big role in shaping the future of our industry. Great praise for Brandon.
All right. Next is Tyler Davis. He's Director of Operations and Sales for Big River Propeller. Davis has helped build Big River Propeller into a very accomplished repair business for the marine industry, said Ron Culp, port engineer for American Commercial Barge Line. Tyler is very ambitious and intelligent. Trent Deloche is next, son of Z Dave. He's currently Vice President of Operations for Deloche Marine Services, Port Allen. Deloche is also a licensed master of towing vessels. And according to Frank Morton, Director of Turn Services, Trent has done an excellent job of moving his company through the maze of Subchapter M while operating 4 company-owned towing vessels and 7 customer-owned towing vessels at a highly efficient and professional level. Z-Dave added, any father would be proud. Brian Duffy, 35, is port captain of compliance for Florida Marine. Duffy began his career on the river at the age of 18 in 2003 as a deckhand for Florida Marine. Brian personifies the mantra that the marine industry, once in your blood, becomes a way of life, said Laura Martin, sales manager for Towworks LLC.
Justin Gentry, 36, is operations manager for Oakey Moore Diving and Marine Salvage LLC in Memphis, Tennessee. He is a certified crane operator, a welder and cutter, a mechanic, and runs the safety program for our salvage crew, said Walter Wepfer, senior vice president of Wepfer Marine Incorporated. Justin ensures everything is done properly and safely and never cuts corners. Joseph Graham, 30, is the manager of line haul vessel operations at Campbell Transportation Company in Houston, Pennsylvania. In addition to running the daily operation of the company's line haul fleet, Graham is a licensed master of towing vessels, a certified emergency medical technician, a former lieutenant in the U.S. Navy Reserve, and was previously a volunteer firefighter in New York. Blake Grimmett, 32, is vice president of barge line operations for Heartland Barge Management, LLC of Columbia, Illinois. Blake's understanding of the commodities market and the factors that influence them have brought a new dynamic to Heartland, said Tim Delaney, Heartland Barge Management vice president.
All right. James Tommy Jocko is 39, techman involved in maintenance and repair for Florida Marine. Tommy was trained by the old guys, the ones who worked hard, never stopped, and always got the job done, said Shannon Jocko, owner and CEO of Barge Transfer Services. He combines that industrious, self-driven attitude with a safety and environmental consciousness that represents the evolution of the industry into what it has become today. And we have Crystal Jones. She is a senior underwriter for the American Equity Underwriters of Mobile, Alabama. Crystal used her prior past experience of customer service experience to help her build productive relationships, resolve issues, and win the loyalty of customers called members at AEU, said Julie Bland. And last on this slide is Josh Jordan, 34. He is the engine block manufacturing manager for National Maintenance and Repair in Hartford, nicknamed 3G. For being the third generation of his family to work for National Maintenance and Repair, Jordan followed the career path of his father and grandfather. Jeff Poston, general manager of National Maintenance and Repair's Diesel Engine Group, praised Jordan's abilities and work ethic.
Next, we have Kiefer Kleinschmidt, 38, fleet manager for the American River Transportation Company, ARTCO, in St. Louis, Missouri. Barrett Looper, consultant with J.W. Terrell in Town and Country, Missouri, credits him in part for what he called world-class safety numbers in the St. Louis Harbor, most recently going more than a year without injury. Cassie Koenig, 37, is office manager for Rushing Marine Services in Jackson, Missouri. Cassie is involved in all aspects of her company, said Todd Rushing, manager of the Rushing Marine. Cassie has made a huge impact on Rushing Marine, our customers, and our industry, Rushing said. Dave Lee, who's 40, is a senior account manager with ABB Marine and Ports in Miramar, Florida. Lee has worked in many different roles in the inland market, first with Jeff Boat, then ACBL, and now with ABB. He is extremely committed to the market and improving the industry, ABB Vice President Ed Schwartz said. John Siknicki, president of Maritime Consulting, LLC, called Lee a driving force transforming the maritime industry.
A lot of you were able to hear Dave speak earlier. He's also a very good presenter, I'll add. And I think it's John Szczynski.
Szczynski?
All right. So Matt Lewis is Vice President of Operations for Genesis Marine in Houston. He has been recognized by his peers for being part of the River Industry Executive Task Force, which is a big deal. Jim Farley, President of Larkspur Consulting, says Matt has the most critical capacity for success in our business. Pretty high praise. Then Travis London, 39, is operations manager and leader of Economy Boat Store's Memphis, Tennessee facility. Travis is an extremely hard worker and takes a hands-on approach to managing our Memphis operation, said David Reynolds. David's vice president of Pilot Thomas Logistics and managing director of Economy Boat. We also got to hear from him today in a session. And last on the slide is James Merrick. He's manager of Wetford Marine's fleet and based in Memphis, Tennessee. Wetford doubled the capacity of Merrick's fleet when the company took on new business, according to Walt Wetford, senior vice president of corporate operations. He took the increase in stride and made many adjustments to handle the new customers, new service requirements, and new employees. He is tenacious and always looking for something to do.
Dan Palin is on this next slide, 39. He's the Director of Marine Safety and Compliance for Brennan Marine Incorporated in La Crosse, Wisconsin. Palin began his career on the river as a deckhand after high school. Dan helped create our internal safety and compliance software and has done a tremendous job in managing the transition to the Sub-M compliance, said Adam Binsfield, president of Brennan Marine Incorporated. Anthony Petrie, Anthony, 31, is first mate on the Charleston for Amherst Medicine in Charleston, West Virginia. Alan Hall, the vice president of operations for Amherst Medicine, called Petrie a top flight mate with an amazing work ethic who is committed to excellence. And finally on the slide, we have Joseph Powell, who's 39. He's the president of Maritime Defense Strategy, LLC, in Gautier, Mississippi. Powell has been a member of the law enforcement community for more than 20 years. He was accepted to join the U.S. Secret Service and provided protection for the United Nations General Assembly ambassadors to the United States. Over the last 10 years, Joseph has brought maritime defense to the next level, said Mark Perry, CEO of Maritime Defense Strategies, LLC.
All right. And there will also be an opportunity to hear from him in a session, Joseph Powell in a session at IMX. And again, these sessions are going to be recorded. So if you miss it, you'll be able to come back on and view it later. All right. So right next, we have Lindsay Price, 35. She's a captain with G&H Towing Company of Galveston, Texas. Of note is that seven people from four different companies nominated Price this year. They all spoke about her leadership, her commitment to mentoring others, her work ethic, and her level of expertise. She mentors young women entering the industry and guides them to successful careers, according to Captain Joy Manti, JMM Marine. Her dedication and respect is well known in the industry. Next, we have Eileen Provins, manager of crewing for Campbell Transportation Company. John Cavins, port captain of Campbell, said that Eileen's attitude sets her apart from others, making her stand out as a leader. He added, Eileen is a bright and shiny star for the industry. Next up, Brian Richard, 39, is chief financial officer for Team Services in Baton Rouge. Along with his role at Team Services, Richard is an active member in the American Waterways Operators, American Equities Underwriters, and Junior Achievement. During his tenure as CFO and part owner of Team Services, the company has increased its sales, numbers, and staff, said Will Hayes. All right.
Scott Riggins. Scott is 35, and he is the general manager of Inland Marine Services based in Hebron, Kentucky. As an up-and-coming maritime leader in our industry, he has gained the respect and admiration of the men and women that he works with daily. And as anyone that who has worked on the river knows, that is no small feat, said Dave Hammond, president of Inland Marine Service. Sarah Robertson, 34, is director of operations for RTI Barge Management Incorporated in O'Fallon, Illinois. Robertson joined RTI nearly 10 years ago and has been instrumental to in both the growth and success of the barge management company. RTI President Rick Husky said she quickly adopted a strong understanding of the river system, barge operations, and freight marketing. Brandon Robertson, 39, is a manager of marine transportation for Pine Bluff Sand and Gravel Company in Salem, Kentucky. Robertson is part of a four-generation family working in the maritime industry. The knowledge and value he brings serves the maritime community and Pine Bluffs in many ways, said Steve Brundrett, Pine Bluffs HSSE director.
Okay, now we have Sarah Stowers. She's 36. She's the chief financial officer of Western Rivers Boat Management in Paducah. Stowers was working for an accounting firm when she was approached by Western Rivers Boat Management to be a full-time employee, said Whitney Cruz, Vice President of Barge Logistics for Marquette. Being completely green to the river and how it operates, the leap of faith was incredible. She has taken on a big role with grace, compassion, and determination. without the photo is Chris Supple. He's relief captain of Campbell Transportation Company. He is a second generation Ohio River towboat pilot. He has a fierce drive and determination. According to Roger Swanson, a deck engineer with Industry Terminal and Salvage of Pennsylvania. And we have Danya Tappan, 38. She's human resources manager for Waterfront Services Company in Cairo, Illinois. Since becoming a human resources manager, she has given personal attention to employees and their needs and concerns, said Alan, company president, Alan Tappan. She does an amazing job and has a bright future ahead of her in this industry, he said.
Travis J. Terrebon, 38, is president of Industrial Diesel Services, LLC, based in Galliano, Louisiana. He continues to push for the growth and advancement of the maritime industry, and we shall remain forever grateful and appreciative for his contributions, said Daniel Babin, managing member of Babin Maritime Consulting, LLC. Dan Wilbrowski, 37, is a vice president of underwater services for J.F. Brennan Company, Incorporated, based in La Crosse, Wisconsin. In 2019, Dan became the vice president of our underwater services group. This is one of the fastest growing groups at Brennan, with more than 60 ADCI certified divers and several topside crews who cover the majority of the continental United States, said Mark Bensfield, vice president of business development for J.F. Brennan.
All right. And last two here, we have Roger Wilson, Jr. He is navigation manager for the Tennessee Tom Bigbee Waterway at the Mobile Engineer District. Roger really excelled in his duties as a civil engineer on the 10-Tom staff, said William Wynn Fuller, chief of the Mobile District's Operations Division. Being a quick study, he soon became an expert in hydrographic surveying, dredging, and navigation block maintenance. Fuller said that in the past 2 years in the role, Wilson has proven to be one of the Corps' most valuable assets. And last, not least, of course, it's all done alphabetically, is Daniel Wolf. Daniel Wolf is safety and compliance officer for Illinois and Michigan Oil, based in Joliet. Leo Catoni, vice president of the Chicago region of ACBL, recognized Wolf for his intelligence, perseverance, commitment, and enthusiasm for the marine industry. So those are our awardees for this year. Of course, I wish we could present them all to you on camera now, but I think our system would crash for sure at that point. but we want to get the word out about how special and how important they are to the industry. Their peers see them as a very bright spot in this industry, and we think they'll be leaders that will continue to have a big part in what we do for years ahead. Again, we're going to be inviting them to attend IMX in person, and we certainly hope that's going to be in May of next year. And at that point, we'll also have an IMX Achievement Award winner, which we weren't able to do this year. I really want to congratulate all. It's been a pleasure for our staff to write about you and learn about you, and be able to recognize you in any way that we can. So congratulations. Lastly, I hope everyone comes back tomorrow. We have another full day of education. We have a full day of an expo hall that you can go to the booths, you can chat with them. So click on each booth, chat with them, learn what they're doing, learn what they're up to, and support our exhibitors and sponsors who really allow us to do this. And so with that, I'll leave you to another good song that's all about things getting better and being the master of your own seas.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of my sea, oh, ooh, the master of my sea, oh, ooh.